A few months ago, the Huffington Post joined with McKinsey & Company, CrowdRise, and the Skoll Foundation to create an innovative program that would help to change the conversation on the employment crisis, the job-raising challenge. This initiative not only raised awareness, it raised over $1.2 million, and that's on top of the $250,000 donation from the Skoll Foundation. The challenge came to a close this weekend and concluded with a nail-biting final hour in which $185,000 was raised. JVSLA wound up beating runners-up Venture for America by a mere $900. But everybody wins because on top of the amounts that each organization raised for themselves, Venture for America will receive an additional $50,000 and JVSLA will receive $150,000.
We had hundreds of blog posts, thousands of tweets. So beyond raising all this serious money, we raised awareness. I mean, a lot more people in America know about JVCLA and know about Venture for America and know about Baker Industries and know about which came third and know about all the other amazing not-for-profits, over 700 finalists. Mm-hmm. And they were from many states, from many cities. So part of what we wanted to do was to show that the media have a responsibility to put the spotlight on good things happening, yep, not just on what is dysfunctional.
This clearly is a winning model. Is there a way to bring this to scale?
Well, absolutely. I think that was something that we were really intrigued by as part of this competition, by offering the platform of the Huffington Post and coming together with CrowdRise, how nonprofits can really use crowdfunding to secure those really hard to come by funds for things that are not secure to their projects. So being able to hire more people in the end to reach, as Vivian mentioned, the real people that are benefiting from this, folks such as Alma.
In the military, I was a corpsman, so I had all sorts of medical skills that I couldn't use as a civilian because it doesn't translate. Mm-hmm. The military, that's where JVS came in. They actually paid for me to get my certification as a phlebotomist, which is something that I did on a daily basis in the Navy, but I couldn't do it as a civilian without going through the state exam, taking the state exam, and it was quite expensive, and they actually paid for it. And after that, they helped me find employment.
What Venture for America does is we recruit top college graduates to work at startups and growth companies in Detroit, New Orleans, Providence, Cincinnati, and Las Vegas. And as you say, Ariana, we're expanding to Baltimore and Cleveland this year in part thanks to the Skoll grant.
I can honestly tell you that JVS changed my life. A year ago, I couldn't find employment. I was at the verge of becoming homeless. That's the darkest. JVS came into my life when I was really, really in need of just unconditional help, and they did. They helped me. I got employment, and to this day, I still reach out to them whenever I need advice, not necessarily financial advice, but the moral support. And I think that's what separates them from the rest of the organizations, that as a veteran, I still need that. I still need that support. And it's the stuff that I find in them. And whenever opportunities like this come across that I have the opportunity to explain and tell my story, I am delighted, I am honored to stand here and tell you that JVS, that changed my life.